मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी स्टार्टेड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग एंड डिक्रीजिंग फंक्शन एंड अंडर दिस वी ऑल्सो स्टडीड स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग एंड स्ट्रिक्टली डिक्रीजिंग फंक्शन. यू रिमेंबर दैट इन द केस ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग वी यूज टू टेक नाउ इंपॉर्टेंट कंडीशन. इन द केस ऑफ डिक्रीजिंग वी टेक दिस वन. When we talk about strictly increasing or strictly decreasing, we take f dash x is greater than 0. This time f dash x is less than 0. This time equal to sign will not be there. The four conditions we have discussed. And two types of question will come. I already have told this. First, show that any function is one of these increasing, decreasing, strictly decreasing in given interval. In this condition, interval will be given. Any interval will be given. A second question, find the interval in which function is one of these. Increasing, decreasing, strictly increasing, strictly decreasing. Maybe anything here. This time you have to find the interval. This time interval will be given. Interval will be given and you have to show that function is whatever. Among these, one of the conditions will be given. This time, find the interval. You have to find the interval in which function is one of these. So, now we discuss, before last day, we discussed two or three questions, but all depending on show that. Now, very first time I'm telling you that find the interval. Look at the condition, I tell you one thing. It's very important to know this question. Very slowly we'll see. Example number 10 we have. Find the interval in which function is strictly increasing and strictly decreasing. It's a very important question. So before doing the question, I want to discuss with you something special. We know that for strictly increasing, this is a condition. F dash x for increasing, f dash is greater than 0. For decreasing, f dash x less than 0. And definitely we can find our answer from this way. So if you will go by this two general method, you also can find the answer. How you can find the answer, I just want to discuss with you. This is f of x. You do differentiation. This will be 2x and this will be 4. If you want to find the answer for strictly increasing, the meaning that in which interval it is increasing and in which interval it is decreasing. So for first case, for first strictly increasing, when you talk about strictly increasing, when you talk about the strictly increasing, f dash x will be taken greater than 0. This is the first method. Even if we have a second method also, which is easy rather than this one. Still, f dash x greater than 0. What is f dash x? 2x, x, 4, 2 by 2, 2. You got answer, x greater than 2. X greater than 2. Meaning in this interval, function is strictly increasing. And if you go on a b, second, strictly decreasing. So what is the definition of decreasing? Strictly decreasing is this one. F dash x less than 0, meaning you will put 2x minus 4 less than 0. 2x less than 4, x less than 2. So whole meaning is this, that in this interval function strictly increasing, in this interval function strictly decreasing. What's whole meaning if you want to make on the graph may be like that. This is 2, this is infinite, this is infinite. For x greater than 2, it is a strictly increasing, meaning graph is just like this. from 2, x greater than 2 meaning 2 to infinite. It is also called 2 to infinite. Let me tell you one thing, it is not equal to sine. So from 2 to infinite meaning, for this we also can write x belongs to 2 to infinite. Don't use the close bracket, because it is not x is equal to 2. When it is x equal to 2, you have to go with a greater than sign. And let me explain something, that in case of strictly, always the condition will come greater than only. It is not equal to sign there. When it is not equal to sign there, it is always open interval. Meaning 2 will not include, infinite definitely not include that. So in whole interval from 2 to infinity, look at the graph, this is strictly increasing. And x less than 2, meaning x less than 2 from minus infinite to 2. Instead of that, what you can write, minus infinite to 2, it is open always. It is also open because it is not equal to sign here. So in this interval particular, look at from left to right, it is strictly decreasing. It is strictly increasing. Now this is a situation. Now we discussed here, this was a method, this is initial method, but I request you, I have a one more method, use that instead of this. Instead of this, use that one only. So what will be that method? Look at, I tell you one very important thing. Can you see the graph? This graph is very good to understand. This is f dash x less than 0. Friend, f dash x less than 0, because it is strictly decreasing. It is f dash x greater than 0. What do you think about this point? This is where the tangent is parallel to this number line on x-axis, something like that. At that point particular, f dash is gonna be 0. F dash is gonna be 0. And this point at which f dash x equal to 0, at this point at which f dash x equal to 0, called a critical point. Called a critical point. This is very important. Look at again what I'm speaking. I'm telling you that at the point at which f dash x is equal to 0, called the critical point, and that is very simple. That critical point is a point from where the graph situation changed. This was strictly decreasing, and this is strictly decreasing. At the particular point, the turn is changed. This was strictly decreasing. At 2, it is changed as a strictly decreasing. Meaning 2 is very important point which actually divides the whole number line in two parts. Minus infinite to 2 and 2 to infinite. So minus infinite to 2, it was strictly decreasing, and 2 to infinite, it was strictly increasing. And very important thing, that student, f dash x is equal to 0 is very important term by which you can find the critical point. And critical point, such a point actually which divides the whole number line in the parts, and in these parts this function change itself. It was strictly decreasing, it is strictly increasing. So critical point is very important. So I don't want to use this in different way, but I just want to use a different method. Let me explain that method right here. This was f dash x equal to 2x minus 4. I want to find equal to 0. Meaning I am taking f dash x equal to 0 so that I can find the critical point. So always keep remember, whenever you want to find, you have a question, this kind of question, whenever you have this kind of question for strictly increasing or strictly decreasing, you student, first do f dash x, then find f dash x equal to 0, meaning find critical point. Well, it will help you like that. So 2x equal to 4, x equal to 2, wow, this is a point which is critical point. And I just want to rough a while, because now you have seen this picture. Seriously, this is a 2, this is minus infinite, this is plus infinite. Now just keep blank your mind, and see that this is a critical point. And now it is come to know that this is a point from where our graph fluctuates. So what kind of fluctuation may be? Hope that perhaps graph is increasing and then decreasing, may be possible. This is still the critical point with the function stop itself. This is the 2 is a point which divides whole number line in two parts. Minus infinite to 2 and 2 to infinite. We don't know that between this function either increasing or decreasing. Maybe graph like that, graph have a two type of way. Maybe it is increasing and then decreasing. Maybe it is decreasing and increasing. So that only the question come in mind, but two is very important point, which is a critical point from where it fluctuates, it turns its way. So we just want to check. Let me clear tell you that how we can check. Now it is only remaining checking. You know, you should know only to know this is a critical point. From minus infinite to 2 and 2 to infinite, we have a two block, two divisions. Between these two, function is either strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Between these two, function is either strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. So we just have to check it. You know that when what we can do for checking, what we do only, we will choose one of the point. We will choose one of the point between 2 to minus infinity, and we will put in f dash x, because we know that when an f dash is positive, meaning it is increasing. When f dash is negative, it is decreasing. So only we can take a one point between 2 to infinite. Okay, we can take, suppose I am taking 1 or 0. 0 is 0, definitely. So we want to take any easy point. Suppose I am taking 0 and I am putting in f dash x. Look at, where is f dash x? This is f dash x. So put f dash x, put x is equal to 0 in this. So what do you feel? 2 into 0 minus 4, meaning answer is negative. So we will just write that in this whole region, f dash x itself negative. Negative. Any point you can put here, like you are putting x equal to 1. So put x equal to 1, 2 1s are 2, minus 4, it is still negative. And just put 2 to infinity, one point, suppose I am taking 3. So put here 3, 3 2s are 6, minus 4 is a positive. Meaning we have checked that in whole this part, minus infinite to 2, f dash x is a negative, and when f dash x is negative, function is strictly decreasing. So this way we can say that therefore, since in interval minus infinite to 2, f dash x is coming negative, so that in this interval function is strictly decreasing, and in interval 2 to infinity, 2 to plus infinity, f dash x is coming positive, so in this interval function is strictly increasing. And keep in mind always, when question may ask without strictly, meaning only increasing or decreasing. So don't worry about same sense, same will come. But only here, near to 2, it is a closed always. Close bracket. Because that time, f dash x equal to 0 also will come. Less than or equal to. And you know that equal to 0 condition only at point 2. So 2 also include in that. Again I speak. If without strictly question is coming, only for increasing and decreasing you have to find the interval. Same procedure will go, same checking will go, but only you have to change the sentence. Since in interval minus infinite to 2, instead of open interval, you have to use a closed interval. And then again write here equal to sign. Because at 2, it is equal to. At 2, f dash x equal to 0. You already know that. At 2, f dash x equal to 0. So just only the thing, whenever strictly is coming, open interval will come near to the critical point. When without strictly word coming, the closed interval will come near to the critical point. That's very simple. So this is a way which we will use in further the question. So okay, one question, it was very long, I stretched, because it was a basic question, and now we will have some more question based on this. So let's look these questions now. Let me take one more question of the same kind. Suppose question is example number 11. Look at the question. It is given f of x equal to 4x cubed minus 6x squared minus 72x and plus 30. Question says, find the interval in which function is strictly increasing and strictly decreasing. So one thing which should come in your mind, that it's just strictly, meaning again, at near to the critical point, it will be used to open interval. Okay. Now procedure will be same, but question with a 3 degree question, no matter at all. But we can solve it. Look at this question. And now, look at what kind of thing may be come. First, I will use the same method. We have to find the interval. And so that, I'll go with f dash x. So find out our f dash x meaning 4 is a 12x squared, 12x and 72. X have a differentiation 1. So I differentiate so-called polynomial. And then taking as usual, f dash x gonna be 0 for critical point. So it is a 12x squared minus 12x minus 72 is equal to 0. Divide by 12, it gonna be like that. And I split in middle term splitting. By middle term splitting, I'll get x minus 3 and x plus 2. No more formality. X is equal to 3 and x equal to minus 2, we have got two answers. X equal to 3 and x equal to minus 2, we have got two answers. And I'll make a number line. So minus infinite to plus infinite. Then we have two points. Last time it was only one critical point. This time we have two critical points. First is minus 3, 3 and minus 2. So keep in mind, always writing from the left and from ascending order. Meaning, less number, shorter number, less number will be written here and then greater will be there. Because the number line always from left to right, it is in ascending order. Like first minus 2 will be here and then 3 will be here. So if you put these two number on the number line, you can see that these two point breaks or divide whole number line in three parts. First part is minus infinite to minus 2. Second is third this. Now we will check. So how we can check? Okay, choose any number between these two. And what is f dash x? Look at f dash x is this one. This looks actually tough. Look at I write again, since we have f dash x is equal to 12x squared, 12x, 72. For your convenient, 12 I take a common. And for your convenient, I just write this one. No matter at all. You also can do it early. But if you have done further, no matter at all. Meaning, that f dash x and that f dash x is similar. Now we can check. Look at. Suppose we have chosen any previous point of minus 2, meaning between these two, we have a minus 3. So if we put minus 3, we don't have to do any formality. We can check by ourselves and write directly the sign. Okay, choose minus 3. Put here minus 3, 12, minus 3, minus 3, minus 6, minus 3 plus 2, minus 1. Overall answer is positive. Positive. Look at, it is a minus 6, it is a minus 1, and it is 12. So whole answer is positive. Meaning, in this interval particular, f dash x gonna be positive. And we should damn sure, not always, but we should assure that between these, if it is a positive, it will be negative. And it is a positive. It is actually, or normally happens, but not always. You have to check. So, minus 2 to 3 will carry 0 as a point, 0. So, you can put here. 0 and 0. So, whole answer is 2, minus 3 and 12. Overall answer is a negative. So, this is answer, f dash x is negative. And this definitely f dash x will be positive. F dash x will be positive. You can put between 3 to infinity, you can choose any number like 4. So if you put 4 here, 4 minus 3 and 4 plus 2, overall answer is a positive. So if you will see whole the number line, we have checked. And now we will write just a formal working, what the formal working is. This is positive and this is positive, meaning in this interval and in this interval, function is strictly increasing. So how will we write? Since in interval, minus infinite to minus 2 and will follow union sign here, meaning combined 3 to infinity, f dash x is coming positive. So in this interval, f of x is strictly increasing. That's first answer done. And since in interval, interval minus 2 to 3, f dash x is coming negative. So in this interval, function is strictly decreasing. And that's over the question. Keep in mind always that it is called strictly word here. If you suppose to having a question without strictly word, won't you just make a change? right? Anything not special here, similar, but here only, when you will write, it is f dash is greater than or equal to 0 will come, and the nearer the critical point, it will be close bracket. Why? Because at the critical point, f dash x was equal to 0. At the critical point. So at near to the critical point, use a close bracket. Here also, minus 2 and 3 both were the critical point. And if you're finding only the case of decreasing case, it will be f dash x equal to 0. And you should know f dash x equal to 0 only happened at critical point, meaning at 2, minus 2 and 3. So both will close because 2, minus 2 and 3 both are critical point. So keep remember, students, this is very important thing which I have told you here. Keep always this in your mind. Okay. Now, we can choose one more question. So this is a base now for whenever the question asks, find the interval. Okay. We have a 12 question, but I'll take a time for this. I just want to write the same question again. Okay, I can tell you, no matter at all. Before starting that, I think it's got enough time today. Already have taught you a lot. Tomorrow we will study example 12, example 13, both are very important. So don't miss tomorrow's class. And you can start exercise 6.2 based on today's teaching. Initial questions are based from 1 to 6. You can make questions from 1 to 6. Thank you.